اذكروني أذكركم واشكروني ولا تكفرون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين. ولا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون.
وأولئك هم المهتدون. جزاك الله خير. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. لازلنا مع سورة البقرة، أطول سورة وأعظم سورة في القرآن. We're still with سورة البقرة. This is the longest سورة and the greatest سورة in the Quran. سورة البقرة or also called سورة البركة. And we last week we talked about the Prophet ﷺ, in the ayah whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِنْكُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ. As we have sent amongst you Rasul, a prophet amongst you, he will recite the kitab, which is the Quran, وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ, and to purify you, وَيُعِلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابُ وَالْحِكْمَةِ, and then he will teach you or to teach you the Quran and the hikmah, and the hikmah here means as-sunnah. So they go together, and we explain that the Quran needs the sunnah more than the sunnah needs the Quran, and we explain as to why the Quran needs the sunnah, because the sunnah explains the Quran. طيب والحكمة ويعذكم ويعلمكم ما لم تكونوا تعلمون. Then Allah subhanahu says فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون. Make mention of me. And the biggest or the greatest ذكر, the greatest ذكر, أعظم الذكر هو القرآن وتلاوة القرآن, كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى. فاذكروني أذكركم. Make a mention of me, I shall make a mention of you. And who are you? Who are we to be mentioned, you know, for Allah Azza wa Jal to be mentioning us by name? You, the sinner, I'm the sinner, I'm the miskeen. يعني أذكر الله عز وجل إذا ذكرت الله الله يذكرني في ملأ خير من هذا الملأ. If you were to mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right now, this is what you're doing. But some people, they think or they claim, جزاهم الله خير, that they're busy and they have other more important things to do. Yes, alhamdulillah. But here what we are, what we're doing, we're making dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're making a mention of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah in return says, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. The more you mention Allah and the more you talk about Allah, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will talk and mention you subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to whom? To a better gathering, the gathering of the angels, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, Allah Azza wa Jal is mentioning right now your names, right now, your names to His angels by name. Isn't that worth, subhanAllah, that you and I sit in here just to get this honor? What kind of honor? Rabbi yadhkurak. Allah to mention you, despite all the sins that you're doing and that I'm doing. And Allah Azza wa Jal, He praises you to His angels. Look at my servants. Look at fulan and look at fulan and look at fulan. Talking about me. فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. And this is where we left off last week. وَاشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Shukr. Shukr is to be grateful. There are two names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we can derive from this concept of a shukr. The name of Allah, Ash-Shakir and Ash-Shakur. We talked about these two names last week. Ash-Shakir, the grateful. So the Shakir, ala wazni fa'il, wa-Shakur, ala wazni fa'ul. They, you know, one is more intensive than the other, right? Ash-Shakir is more intensive than Ash-Shakur. And they both describe this quality of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is By the way, how is Allah Shakur? How is Allah Shakur? Allah is Shakur, Shakir, which is different than Alhamd, Shukr, Alhamd. Shakur, Allah is thankful, thankful to you. The hadith says, there's a hadith that explains this. If you were to find, that the Prophet ﷺ says, something harmful on the way, and then you remove it from people's way, because it's harmful. فَشَكَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ فَغَفَرَ لَهُ. A man found something harmful, and then he removed it from people's way. فَشَكَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Allah was grateful to his action, and he forgave him. This is what it means for the name of Allah, الشَّكَرَ الشَّكُورَ. To thank you, Shakur. Allah does not need me to do anything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is al-ghani, and I am al-faqir, right? Yet, when you do something good, Allah is thankful to that particular action that you have done. Although Allah is not in need of you to do that or this, but Allah Azza wa Jalla from His quality is ash-shakur. Allah, thank you. And the Prophet says, "Man lam yashkur in-nas, lam yashkur Allah." Or "Man lam yashkur Allah, lam yashkur in-nas." Whoever does not thank people, he doesn't thank Allah. You say shukr. And hamd is different. Shukr can happen to you as a person, and also to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the Lord. Shukr for both you, the human, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord. But alhamd is only befitted to Allah. Alhamd is not befitted to a person. Whereas a shukr to a person and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. I can say thank you. Ashkuruk, shukran lak. ولكن ما نقول أحمدك استغفر الله الحمد هو لله بس الحمد is only befitted to Allah سبحانه وتعالى تشكره على نعمه ما شاء الله هذا حيمر علينا كده ويلف يلف يلف خلاص خذوا من عنده التمر وزا الله خير ما شاء الله عليك thank you very much أيوة no. طيب طيب الله put it down and خلينا نخلص أيوة نعم ما شاء الله now you're gonna become a celebrity جزاك الله خير تمر Thank you, Bismillah. Thank you. MashaAllah. Show kif. Are the angels going on earth? تشكره على نعمه سبحانه وتعالى. تشكره. You thank him for his bounties. You thank him for the favors. The favor that, you know, Allah, brothers, you know, excuse me for this. You and I will not know the value of this sitting until you and I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will not know the value of this gathering that you and I are sitting here today until the day we meet Allah azza wa jalla, and then you see the merits and the favors and you say, I wish I did not miss any of these events or the series. Alhamdulillah, you're sitting ni'mah from Allah. You prayed maghrib. Isn't that ni'mah? Ni'mah. Because a lot of people didn't pray. But some people did pray. And some people prayed in the masjid, in their homes. You prayed in the masjid, despite all your busy schedule. And you prayed and you sat down to listen to my 25 cents worth of advice. This is ni'am. Ni'am. You're not here because you're handsome. Allah, you have beautiful hair. Allah, because you're smart. Or because you're wealthy. Or healthy. You're here because Allah chose you to be here. There are people who are healthier than you. And wealthier than you. And more handsome than you. And beautiful hair than you. But they're not here. So it is Allah. That's why you should say Alhamdulillah. And the opposite of shukr is kufr. And we talked about this last week. The opposite of shukr is kufr. Kufr of what? Kufr of ni'am. You say ni'mat. Kufr of the ni'mat of Allah. You are not thankful of enough to the ni'am, to the bounties, to the favors that Allah Azza wa Jalla has blessed you with. وَالشُكْرُ ثَلَاثَ أَقْسَى. And shukr is of three categories. شُكْرُ الْقَلْبِ شُكْرُ اللِّسَانِ وَشُكْرُ الْجَوَارِحِ Shukr of the qalb, first of all. How can I thank Allah by heart? Na'am. To thank Allah by heart is by recognizing the ni'mah of Allah. Please listen to this very carefully. I am thanking Allah by my heart, by virtue of my heart. How? How? By recognizing the ni'mah that Allah has blessed you with. Then that will transfer to the shukr of al-lisan, then you will say alhamdulillah. First it starts with the heart. You're recognizing the ni'mah that Allah has blessed you with, the ni'mah of the kids, the ni'mah of the masjid, the ni'mah of an imam, the ni'mah of your spouse, the ni'mah of your daughter, the ni'mah of the sihha. Because a lot of us are oblivious of the ni'mah of Allah. A lot of us don't pay attention to this little, because it just, but once you know, once you lose it, you know, then you will value it. This is why it's very important to recognize the ni'mah, to recognize the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْإِعْتِرَافُ بِهَا وَالْإِعْتِرَافُ بِالْمُنْعِمِ. And also to recognize the mun'im is the one who bestowed the ni'mah, Allah. Because the ni'mah, it is not from yourself. The ni'mah is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the shukr by heart, number one. Number two, once you realize that and recognize that it transfers to, you will say alhamdulillah, which means ash-shukr bil lisan, by tongue. Wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith bil lisan. Haddith, talk about the ni'am of Allah upon you. Some may say, please don't understand or don't misunderstand this. Shaykh, I don't want to talk too much about the ni'mah of Allah because people will give me the evil eye. Sah. Sah, you have to be careful though. Allah says, وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Talk about the ni'mah of Allah by making shukr to Allah. Yes, I have kids. And then some people don't have no kids. And then you can have, I have a doctor, mashallah, and I have Hafid al-Quran. And you have this other person who miskeen has no kids. Maybe that person, he will look at you without saying mashallah, and he will give you the evil eye. And then the girl will say, alhamdulillah, someone came and I just married this very successful person. Look at that. And then this woman who's been sitting there for years trying to find a husband for her daughter and nothing is happening. And then you just say, yeah, my daughter, alhamdulillah, just yesterday, khalas, done, alhamdulillah, someone came and then moved on and it all worked out. Then be careful. And some of the mistakes that some of our youth are doing today, on the Fasad book and social media and whatnot. You know, all these, and then they start taking pictures of their weddings and then sharing it with the whole world. I think for me it's a big mistake. Why? Somebody from very far can give it to you. Because what is the evil eye? Siham. Min siham al-shaytan. Like arrows. They could come from very far. A person who looks at that, wow. Say alhamdulillah, say mashallah, ish wow hadi. Ish wow, wow. Wow, subhanallah. But who says wow, mashallah? No, they only say wow. What a wedding. What, wallah, this girl, she came in with her hair. It's true, we have so many stories, but just beautiful hair. She came out to this wedding, and they look, oh, wow, beautiful hair. She lost her hair a week later, cancer. How many people say mashallah? So this is why you have to be careful. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Yes, talk about the ni'mah of Allah through being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then that will transfer to the shukr of the jawarih. The shukr of, from the lisan, comes in the physical faculties. يعني, your eyes should make shukr, not to look at haram, look at halal. That's shukr of, you know, by eyes. Shukr of the hand, by, you know, giving sadaqah, by doing something. Shukr of the feet, shukr of, you know, this is how one should make shukr by the physical faculties. And the Prophet Muhammad, you know the story when he used to make qiyam al-layl. When Aisha, she told him, Ya Rasulullah, he used to make qiyam al-layl for so long that his feet, his heel were cracked, right? The hadith, cracked in his feet, in his heels. Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, why do you do this to yourself? وَقَدْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. Allah has already forgiven you all your sins. Why? What did he say? أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. From shukr, shouldn't I be a thankful slave? So he's using his health, his strength, his hands, his feet, his by praying. This is shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Who is he talking to? The Sahaba. Right? Yeah, the Sahaba. But the Sahaba are already dead. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Oh, you who believe. He's not talking to me. He's talking to the Sahaba. The Sahaba are gone. But the Sahaba are gone. But the message is for يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Oh, you who believe. Are you آمَنُوا? Are you مؤمنون? Inshallah. Inshallah. I am a mu'min. I am a mu'min. I am a Muslim. I am a mu'min. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. You are a mu'min, inshallah ta'ala. Until then. But now I am a mu'min. And I say it by tongue. I am a mu'min. I believe. I believe in la ilaha illallah. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. That means the message is to you. Ya Allah. What do you have to say? What is the message? Ista'inu bis sabri was salah. Inna allaha ma'a as-sabirin. Seek comfort with what? Seek comfort. He doesn't say in what. He just said seek comfort through bisabri, with sabr. Sabr yani patience. And salah. Salah means salah. Inna Allah ma'a sabirin. We will spend maybe the whole night here in this ayah. Allah is with as-sabirin. Oh? But Allah is everywhere, is with all. Some people said Allah is everywhere, which is wrong, by the way. Huh? Hold on, Sheikh. What is Allah? Beta? What is Allah? Where is God? What is Allah? Good job. Allah is in the heavens, ascended on His throne. So those who say Allah is everywhere, they're very mistaken. Allah is above, but He's everywhere with His ilm, with His knowledge. He knows everything with His knowledge. But where is He? Allah is in the heavens. Who said? A woman, she came to Rasulullah claiming that she was a believer. Then the Prophet says, we have to test her. Ayn Allah? The very first question he asked her, Ayn Allah? قالت في السماء. من أنا رسول الله؟ هذه مؤمنة. Who is Allah? She's in the heavens. Who am I? Rasulullah. She's right away he testified, she's a believer. So, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ Allah is with صابرين. What does that mean? We'll talk about it إن شاء الله تعالى. بعدما ذكر الله اذكروني أذكركم واشكروني ولا تكفرون ثم ذكر الصلاة والصلاة من أعظم الذكر. من أعظم الذكر. After Allah عز وجل talked about اذكروني أذكركم. Right? Remember? اذكروني ذكر أو ذكر. After he talks about ذكر, he talked about الصلاة. Why salah? Because as-salah is the greatest form of dhikr. Who do you talk to in the salah? If you want Allah to talk to you, what do you do? Quran. You read Quran. And if you want to talk to Allah, what do you do? The salah. So you know this. من أعظم الذكر. Then Allah عز وجل tell Prophet Muhammad, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. لِذِكْرِي الذِّكْر. Establish the salah li dhikri, as a, you know, to make a mention of me. If you want to remember me, do the salah, ya Rasulullah. The entire religion is built upon patience. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ya ladina aminu sta'inu bis sabri was salah. Why this connection right there? Why as-sabr and why as-salah? You do know why, brothers? And I'm going to talk about this and explain it to you. You're going to love it, inshallah ta'ala. Doesn't the salah requires patience? By the way, what made you stay here? You're sitting. You just, like you said, you want to drink the tea and you want to leave. Because he says, Sheikh, should we change this? And I said, we need to do mashura. All right? Can we change the sequence? We drink the tea first and then do the halaqa next. I said, yes, but if we drink the tea first, khalas, there's no more halaqa. Where's the halaqa? ولكن, aren't you sitting? Don't you need sabr? You need sabr. You need patience for you being sitting right here. You need patience to read the Quran. You need patience to come to the masjid. You need patience to pray. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, when He says, with regard to استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة, يعني in the salah, you need this sabr. You need this patience. العبادة كلها تحتاج إلى صبر. العبادة كلها العبادة, you know what عبادة, right? Yes or no? عبادة, عبادة, worship in its entirety requires صبر. الذكر يحتاج إلى صبر. ذكر requires صبر. You think I'm just gonna sit here then? No, you need صبر. Because all of a sudden you'll be making subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, and then I'm tired. But you're not tired browsing through your phone for hours. You don't get tired, huh? But you're only tired when subhanAllah, alhamdulillah. You get tired when you read the Quran. Like you go to the one page. Oh yeah, one page. I'm finished. You just want to, alas, move on. You get tired. You need sabr. In everything but ibadah, you need sabr. Qiraat al-Quran, you need sabr. You sit in here, you need sabr. كل نجاح في الدنيا والآخرة يحتاج إلى صبر. Success in this life and the life of the hereafter requires صبر. يا أخي, even in our businesses, you start a business or whatnot, don't you need patience to see that tree growing? Does anybody plant a tree and the tree grows right away? Don't they say tree grows in silence? Have you heard this expression? A tree grows in silence. It grows slowly. In its, you know, patience for it. So this is why, subhanAllah, in anything that you do, it requires some sabr. فَبِالصَّبْرِ تَسْتَمِرُّ الصَّلَاةِ. بِالصَّبْرِ تَسْتَمِرُّ الصَّلَاةِ. In Ramadan, تراويح. You hear. Don't you need sabr to go through the 20 rak'ah? يا أخي, 20 rak'ah. And then some people say, لا لا لا, Prophet never prayed 20. Which is true. Prophet only prayed 8. Only prayed 8. خلاص, صلى الله عليه وسلم. I'm going to do 8. و8 ويعني ها. I'm really struggling to pray 8. Don't you need sabr for that? Through patience we endure our prayers. فلا بد من هذه المعادلة. أيش هي المعادلة؟ الصبر من جهة والصبر من جهة أخرى. معادلة. We need this equation. It's very essential. The equation of what? صبر from one side. And what's from the other side? Tell me. What are we talking about here, man? I'm just talking and talking and talking, blah, blah, blah. As-sabr from one side and? Salah. طب انت يا حبيبي, what am I talking about? As-sabr and as-salah. As-sabr as-salah. So we need sabr from one side. This is the mu'adala. This is the equation. Sabr, salah. We need them together, right? So you need sabr from one side. Why salah? Here, why salah? The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah عز وجل تزم سورة الحجر, وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّهُ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. يا محمد, we know that your heart, that your breast, you know, that you've been hurt because of what they're saying about you. Maybe they're calling you names. Now they're calling you names. They're calling you مجنون. They're calling you ساحر. They're calling you كذاب. That hurts you. يا رسول الله, that hurts you. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّهُ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُنْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. فالعبادة تحتاج إلى صبر. They've been swear, they've been cursing Rasulullah, they're calling him names and whatnot. So what did Allah tell him to do, you know, when he's going through this emotional distress? Ya Rasulullah, tie to the salah. فَسَبِّحْ تَسْبِيحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُنْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ. And be from those who are making sujood. That means be from those who are praying. So this praying, this salah, requires sabr. They go together. This is why I talked about this this al-mu'adala. Sabr and salah. Right, this after this ayah was revealed, إِذَا حَزَنَهُ أَمْرَ عَلَيْهِ صَلَّى السَّلَامِ بَادَرَ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. إذا حزبه أمر بدر إلى الصلاة. Right away, when this ayah was revealed, when the Prophet goes through any difficulties, he will rush to the salah. What did he used to tell Bilal? Tell me. أرحنا بها يا بلال, didn't he? He used to tell Bilal, يا بلال, we need to have some rest, some comfort. Go make adhan so we can pray. He's sitting with his family. I am not in comfort right here. I'm not at comfort. Go, Bilal, make a dance so that we can pray. There, I will find my comfort. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَإِذَا حَزَبَكَ أَمَرْ. Please listen to this. إِذَا حَزَبَكَ أَمَرْ ضَاقَتْ بِكَ الدُّنْيَا. وَأَنَا بَكَلَّمْ نَفْسِي. ضَاقَ عَلَيْكَ شَيْءٍ. ضَاقَ رِزْقُكَ أَوْ قَلَّ رِزْقُكَ. فَعَلَيْكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. صَلِّ. if something troubles you, if you go through hardship, difficulties, rush towards as-salah. The salah is the key. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. Another ayah. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ أَوْ مُحَمَّدْ. Tell your family, enjoin them to tell them to pray in, you know, أَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. وَاسْطَبِرْ, be persistent. Brother, when you wake up your kids to pray, do they tell you, yes, Abu, right away? Right away. You have angels. You have angels. You keep waking them up. You keep telling them, ya fulan, ya fulan, ya alan, get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. And then sunrise. And then if somebody who has 15 kids, he will never pray in the masjid, maybe. And he waits until he wakes them up. Oh, rahat alayhi salam. He has to get from Salat al-Dhuhr, he will wake them up until Asr. Miskin in Africa, some people will complain about this. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet, wastabir alayha, be persistent. La nas'aluka rizqa, Allahu yarzuqak. We don't ask you for any rizq, for any sustenance. Who sustains you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. استعينوا بالصبر استعينوا استعينوا seek comfort, as I said, استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. But Allah does not say in what, He just says seek comfort in صلاة. But يا ربي seek comfort in what يعني with, I'm sorry, He says seek comfort with patience and perseverance or صلاة, I'm sorry, seek comfort with patience and صلاة. But seek comfort in what? He does not say what. Seek comfort على دينك ودنياك بالصلاة, على آخرتك بالصلاة, على أعدائك بالصلاة, على أمراضك بالصلاة, على حياتك بالصلاة, على كل أمر استعين بالصبر والصلاة. Everything in your deen, seek comfort in صلاة. In your dunya, seek comfort in صلاة. At your enemies, seek comfort in salah. Your sicknesses, seek comfort in salah. This is why the there's an emptiness right there. So it's like a question mark. It's for all. Anything that comes to your mind, seek comfort in patience and salah. Your life, seek comfort in sabr and salah. We say in Arabic, as-sabr miftah al-faraj. As-sabr miftah. You know what miftah? The key. In Urdu? Chabi. Huh? Chabi. Chabi. He's Chabi. As-sabr is the key to Chabi. Is the key to relief. You want relief? You need patience. Patience is bitter, but salah is sweet. You mix the bitter with the sweetness, you have sabr and salah. As-sabr miftah al-faraj. Then the Prophet Muhammad السلام, the hadith that says, you know, when he spoke to Abdullah ibn Abbas, Ya bunay, ihfadi Allah yahfadak, ihfadi Allah tajidu rijak, idha sa'alta fas'ali Allah, wa idha ista'anta fasta'in billah. Wa'alam. The hadith is long, and then he says at the end, Wa'alam anna ma'an anna al-nasr ma'a al-sabr. وأن الفرج مع الكرب مع مش بعد وأن الفرج مع الكرب وأن مع العسر يسرا. Oh son, oh beloved, oh boy, oh my son, يا بني. Then he tells him, احفظ الله يحفظك. Be mindful of Allah. Allah will protect you. Be mindful of Allah. You shall find Him near you, with you. When you ask, ask Allah. When you seek refuge in, seek refuge with the help of Allah. And then he tells him, you know, some advice, and at the end he says, and rest assured that victory comes with patience. You want victory in Palestine? We want victory? We need to be patient. وَالْفَرَجْ مَعَ الْكَرْبِ. And relief comes with hardship. Relief comes with hardship. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يسرا. إنما على العسر يسرا. Allah did not say بعد العسر يسرا. بعد means after. Allah says with. With hardship comes ease. With hardship comes relief. And brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also ordained Bani Israel. I'm going to go to Bani Israel now. With sabr and salah. Did they abide? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَتِي أَلَّتِي أَنْعَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكْبِرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. Right? In Surah Al-Baqarah, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ, remember my favors upon you. وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ, and I favored you upon الْعَالَمِينَ. And Allah says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ. يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ, O children of Israel, استعينوا, seek comfort in what يا ربي, seek comfort in patience and salah, in patience and salah. Were they patient? ماذا فعل بني إسرائيل؟ Were they patient? Huh? When they were ordered to enter the القرية, you know, Palestine, they did not. لا إن فيها قوما جبارين. No. There is some, you know, tyrants in there. We shall not enter it. When they were told to slaughter the cow, did they show patience? No, they did not show patience. They kept on raising doubts. When صبرهم ضعيف. The صبر is very weak, except المؤمنين. Compare that with our صبر today. Compare that with the sabr of well, they were told not to fish. Just one day, man. Just Saturday, don't fish. And then you can fish another day. لا ما في صبر. No sabriye. No sabr. And compare our sabr today of the children of Palestine, the moms and dads in Palestine. The mother who lost everything, the father who lost everything. What can they do? Other than إِنَّ لِلَّهُ وَإِنَّ رَجِعُونَ لِلَّهِ مَا أَخَذْ وَلَهُ مَا أَعْطَى. That belongs to Allah. Allah took whatever He gave us. Allah is Al-Warith. Is one of the names of Allah, Al-Warith. The supreme inheritor. He inherited, He gave us, and He took back what He inherited, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything belongs to Allah. Look at the sabr. With Musa. Oh, tafsir is so sweet. Musa, what did they tell? What did the people of Musa told Musa? اذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا إنها هنا قاعدون. Didn't they say that to Musa? When he says, let's go, you know, you need to go and take out these tyrants from Palestine. And they said, اذهب أنت وربك فقاتلا. أنت وربك, go with your Lord and fight. We shall sit right here. What did the Muslim Sahaba in Badr told Prophet Muhammad when they came out? They were not ready for war. They did not even know that they were going to battle in Badr. They were going after what in Badr? Wait. After the caravan, after the business, after the trade. It's our money. It's our belongings from Mecca. Quraysh took them and they were going to Sham to trade, to business, right? So they're going after their own wealth. And then Allah Azza wa Jal orchestrated, even the land was orchestrated by Allah Azza wa Jal. Then they are, what do you say, amam al-waqi'. Amam al-waqi'. They were put in, تحت amam al-waqi'. Under reality? Maybe? And they faced it. They said, okay, this is what it is. There is no caravan. You're here to fight. So the Prophet collected them and then, أَشِيرُوا عَلَيَّ أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. You know the story. أَشِيرُوا عَلَيَّ أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ. Tell me, you people, what do you think? Should we go and fight? What should we do? The caravan now has took a different route. So what should we do? What should we do? Abu Bakr stood. Where Ya Rasulullah? Jazakallah khair, Abu Bakr. Sit down. And another muhajir stood, Ya Rasulallah. And then Jazakallah khair, sit down. And then one of the Ansari stood up and says, Ya Rasulallah, as if you're meaning us with the Ansar. As if you're meaning us with the Ansar. We shall not tell you what Banu Israel told Musa. Idhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila, go with your Lord and fight. We are sitting right here. We shall tell you, go anta wa rabbuka faqatila, inna ma'akuma muqatilun. We shall tell you, go on your Lord and fight, and we shall be with you fighting, Ya Rasulullah. Even if you tell us to cross this ocean, we shall cross it, Ya Rasulullah. And they had nothing. They showed patience. رضي الله عنهم وأرضاهم. When Allah Azza wa Jalla, as I mentioned, حرم عليهم صيد البحر. ومن أغلى صيد البحر ولا صيد البر؟ صيد البر أغلى من صيد البحر. The example I've gave a few times here, you know, when they were prohibited from fishing, but subhanAllah, the hunting in land is more valuable than the fishing of the sea. Why? Because they failed to abide by the order given by Allah. Don't fish. Well, as the Muslims, when they were going, remember when they were going to the Hajj, to the Umrah with their ihram, and then the deers were coming so close to them, and they were avoiding them because they were not supposed. Why? Because while I'm in ihram, I should not hunt. I must not hunt. Not shouldn't. I must not. So they were avoiding. So they've been tested right there. Those failed, but the Muslims succeeded. وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. I'm going to talk about this very, very important. Because a lot of you and I, we say, I'm patient. I'm going to ask you some very deep questions. I'm patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. لماذا؟ لَأَنَّ لَنْ يُمْكِنُكَ أَنْ تَصْبِرْ إِلَّا إِذَا صَبَّرَكَ اللَّهِ. خلاص. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet Muhammad, be patient, for your patience is only with Allah's help. Which means you cannot be patient unless Allah helps you to be patient. Example, Hamza. You know who Hamza is? Ibn Abi Talib. When he was killed, he got disfigured before when they killed him. Right? You know the story. فهموا بفعل ما بمثل ما فعلوا به هم رسول الله وصفية صفيه she is the auntie رسول الله the صفيه she is the auntie huh صفيه she is the auntie of the prophet what's her relationship with حمزة صفيه الحمزة دي what أيها المسلمون this I'm telling you صفيه she is the auntie of رسول الله And Hamza is the uncle of Rasulullah. So Safiya and Hamza, they are what? Husband and wife. Why Samhak? Husband and wife. Safiya, bint Abd al-Muttalib. They are sister, brother and sister. Ukhtu. Ukhtu. I'll beat you up, guys, huh? I'll hit you, huh? I'll hit you. I'm going to lose it, huh? Husband and wife. Safiya, she is the auntie of Rasulullah, and Hamza is the uncle. And Safiya and Hamza, they're the brothers and sisters. So they intended to do as it was done to Hamza, to the killer of Hamza, to kill him, but not just to disfigure everything. You know. So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, "وَإِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ وَإِنْ عُوقِبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا عَاقَبْتُمْ بِهِ." وَلَئِنْ صَبَرْتُمْ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلصَّابِرِينَ صَبَرْتُمْ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلصَّابِرِينَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you retaliate, they claim to do even worst. Oh, they did this to Hamza, we go into the worst. Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed, if you retaliate, let it be equivalent to that which you have suffered. Don't do worse. Don't do something you know, more than, you know, somebody, يعني, he hit you, you hit him back. But Allah says, وَلَئِنْ صَبَرْتُمْ لَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلصَّابِرِينَ But if you are, if you endure patience, it is better for the صابرين. So what did Prophet Muhammad صلى said? The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله in قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, إِذَنْ وَاللَّهِ لَنَصْبِرَنَّ إِذَنْ وَاللَّهِ لَنَصْبِرَنَّ Then, وَاللَّهِ we shall be patient. And then صافية said, وَاللَّهِ we shall be patient. We will not even do that again. You know, to the one who did this to our brother and to the Prophet Muhammad, to our uncle, we shall be patient. إنما الصبر عند الصدمة الأولى. Beautiful patience. People who say they claim and they complain and complain and complain and complain. They did this to me and they did this to me. And then what they say? الحمد لله. الحمد لله. Or an Arabic woman, she says, خليني ساكتة. Don't you have this in your culture? You know, she complains and complains. She says, let me be quiet. You said, yeah, the whole day she was talking. And he says, let me be silent.
I'll keep it in my heart.
Yeah, she has to vent. It has to come out. And at the end, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah is no good now. Alhamdulillah is no good. إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرَ عِنْدَ الصَّدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. Beautiful patience happens when? At the first strike. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ لِلَّهِ مَا أَخَذْ وَلَهُ مَا أَعْطَى. To Allah will belong and to Him we shall return. Look at the Sahaba when they came back to Mecca. When they came back, when they migrated to Medina. They lost everything. كانوا أثرياء. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, because we're going to explain the Qur'an with the Qur'an. They were rich. A lot of them were rich. Like Uthman, like Abu Bakr. فَأَصْبَحُوا فُقَرَاءَ فِي مَكَّةِ. They lost everything. In Mecca they came, they were like poor. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, لِلْفُقَرَاءِ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ الَّذِينَ أُحْصَرُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ ضَرْبًا فِي الْأَرْضِ يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفِ. تَعْرِفُهُمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ. لَيْسَ لُنَا النَّاسَ إِلْحَافًا. The muhajirin, this poor muhajirin who migrated fi sabilillah. And then the Prophet says, يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ. The jahil, the heedless, will think that they are rich, that they are wealthy, because these people, they are chaste. They don't ask around. They're so poor, yet they don't ask around. So if you think, if you see them, there are some people who come to the masjid, they are so much in need, but you and I, we think that they are so well off. Why? Because they don't ask. They don't ask. Like the Sahaba here. Faqr, poverty, sickness. What kind of sickness? Humma Yathrib. Very well known. Humma Yathrib. The plague of Yathrib. Yathrib is what? Is the old name of Medina. It used to be called Yathrib. And was known, Yathrib was known of these diseases. Yathrib was known to be gloomy, to be sad. Subhanallah, before the coming of the Prophet, this was what was called Yathrib, was known to have lots of diseases. When Prophet came, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is why it's called Al-Madina Al-Munawwara. His nur illuminated Medina, so it's no more called Yathrib. It was known, subhanallah, look. It was known for the land to be not fertile, very bad land, very gloomy land, sick land. When Prophet Muhammad came, not just the air, everything changed. Even the land and the earth and the sand and the dust changed. The Prophet Muhammad will touch the earth of Medina if somebody is sick. And he will take this and then touch the land. He will suck his thumb, put his thumb on his on the earth of Medina. طُلْبَةُ أَرْضِنَا بِرِيقَةِ بَعْضِنَا يُشْفَى رَقِيمُنَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّنَا. Turbatu ardina, the turbat, the turba, yani the dust of the earth of our lands, with the mixed with the saliva, you know, yushfa saqimuna, and he would put it on somebody who's sick. Yushfa from shifa of the one who's sick with the order of Allah subhanahu wa taala. Abu Bakr got sick and poor, and Uthman got sick and poor, and Bilal got sick and poor, but the people did not know, muhajirin, but they are chaste. Nobody knew that they were sick. And then the Prophet Muhammad made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he saw a dream. Do you want me to tell you what the dream is? Or shall I do next week? Huh?
Yeah, tell us.
25?
It's a lot of time.
A lot of time?
This week.
Huh?
This week is good, inshallah.
This week is good? Tayyim, yallah. Because Turkey is here, we're gonna finish, inshallah. The Prophet saw a dream. رأى امرأة سوداء دائرة الرأس أو كما جاء في الحديث خرجت من المدينة إلى الجحفة. He saw a dark woman with a round face coming out from Medina into the outskirts of الجحفة area, far from Medina. أصبح الناس وكأن لم يصبهم مرض قط. They were patient, but when people woke up, as if the plague has never entered Medina. And then the Prophet says, this plague has left Medina. I saw a dream, and the dream is, this dark woman is the plague. It left Medina, and it will never come back again. They were patient. And Allah Azza wa Jal, Ash-Shakur, Allahu Akbar. Ash-Shakir, he was great. Allah Azza wa Jalla thanked them for being patient, so he cured them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you understand now? You can see the beauty of the Quran, the tafsir. بعدما كانت أرضها وباء صارت أرضها بركة. The earth of Medina was filled with sicknesses. With the coming of Rasulullah, it became shifa. And subhanAllah, the Prophet says, I will witness in one hadith. I will be the witness in one hadith. I will intercede to whoever dies in Medina. Whomever dies in Medina. Arabi, Pakistani, Hindi, Turkey, Chinese. Who dies in Medina, gets buried in Medina, and the Prophet Muhammad will intercede on their behalf. Medina wasn't like that before. But the Sahaba, why I'm doing this? To connect the dots of sabr and the beauty of sabr. Fada'is sabr. He's talking about the merits of sabr. And please remember this, inshallah, try to remember this. Sabr is of three categories. As-sabr yanqasimu aw qasamahu al-ulama ila thalath aqsam. As-sabr lillah wa as-sabr billah wa as-sabr ma'a Allah. إيش هالكلام ده؟ الصبر لله and بالله and مع الله. What does that mean? لله means الصبر for Allah. الصبر لله ولربك فاصبر لله. I'm being patient for Allah. For Allah. This. Okay, if you tell me what it is, I'm going to wake you up because you're almost dozing off. And those who are dozing off, I'm for sure is jinn. And I'm no doubt. If you need me to do ruqya on you, that will wake them up now. What is the connection when we say for Allah? What's the concept that we're talking about here? Sabr for Allah. It has to do with what then? Very well known concept that we own. You know it for sure. Very important. You will not enter the Jannah. You will. Min galha? Allah yizak al-khair. Ikhlas. Patient for Allah. I'm not being patient for you, so you can give me that job. I'm not patient for you, Sheikh, so give me the tea after the halaqah. In fact, I'm going to prove to you. I'm going to stand for the halaqah after when you. And I love your tea, but I'm not going to take no tea from you. Ya Allah, challenge. صبر لله صبر لله على إيش صبر لله على طاعته وعلى معصيته وعلى قدره وعلى قدره سبحانه وتعالى لله for Allah on what? On his obedience and on his disobedience and his qadr. Very very important. Please listen up with your heart, not your ears. Very important. صبر patience for Allah in terms of obedience. When I obey Allah Azza wa Jal, ta'at Allah, the ta'at, the obedience of Allah, I need sabr. So I'm being patient for His sake. I'm here trying to obey Allah Azza wa Jal for His sake. So patience for Allah in terms of obedience. And also disobedience. I could have gone somewhere, man, and do something haram. But I'm not going to do that. I'm being patient. When at work, at school, the things happening there, it's so easy to commit haram nowadays. So easy, isn't it? But I'm going to be patient for who? Patient for Allah in terms of disobedience. I'm not going to disobey. وعلى قضائه وقدره قدره سبحانه وتعالى إذا صار شيء رضيت بالله رضيت بالله في السراء والضراء. هذا هو الصبر على قضاء الله. And when something happens to me, this is the third time. Al-Qadr, the Qadr, Qadr of Allah. You know Qadr? Qadr, Qaza, Qaza and Qadr. You say Qaza. The Qadr or Qada of Allah. The decree of Allah. I'm going to be patient. Allah takes from me, I'm going to be patient for. No. I don't want people to say I'm being patient. La, I'm doing it for Allah. This is called Sabru Lillah. If I lose money, if I lose this, I lost a loved one. صبر لله على قضائه وفي السراء والضراء. Whether I'm going through difficulties or through good and bad, whether through thin or thick, الصبر لله. That's number one. Number two, الصبر بالله. الصبر بالله. You see the difference? لي and بي. Even the Arabs, they may be confused here. So rest assured, okay? That's what I'm trying to explain here. Li and bi. There's a difference between li and bi in Arabic. Lillah is for Allah. Billah. Wasbir wa ma sabruka illa billah. What's the difference? It's just sabr. La, there's a difference between lillah and billah. Lillah is for Allah. Billah is with the help of Allah. With the help. I cannot be patient until Allah or unless Allah helps me to be patient. So I need the sabr. Billah. With Allah. With the help of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see the difference here. You think you're patient here. You know, you could have gone a long time ago and go home, right? But you're here because Allah Azza wa Jal is helping you to be patient, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be able to sit here, to go through all this. As-sabr billah. Wa kaman ala ta'atihi, wa ala ma'asiyatihi, wa ala qadaihi, wa ala qadaihi, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Same thing. Billah for the obedience, billah for his disobedience, and billah for his qada'. I need the help of Allah to be patient because you know that girl that's keep on bothering you. If Allah did not help you to be patient, you could have gone with her and did something haram, but Allah has helped you to stay away from her. That girl that keeps on bothering you at work, you too, because you're handsome. And she comes and says, I'll marry you. You tell her, I am married. She says, I know, but in Islam, it tells you that you can have a, right? Yeah. Alright, I got you, right? And then, but Allah helped you to be patient to that. Fasting, Allah helped you to be, because it's all there, it's so easy. You could have said, I'm sick today. I am really sick today and I want to do this. I have a headache, so I have an excuse. La, I am here. Many times you could have, subhanAllah, you were about to slip. But Allah Azza wa Jalla helped you to be sabr billah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh, I have something very, very nice, especially for you. وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. And then, first and second, they will lead to, number three, الصَّبْرُ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Oh, مَعَ. You know what مَعَ is in Arabic? مَعَ means? With. With. مَعَ. 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 أَعْلَى مَرْتَبَةِ الصَّبْرِ. ليش؟ لأن فيها معية الله. إن تصل إلى مقام الإحسان في الصبر هو استشعار معية الله معك. So this is the highest category of صبر. صبر مع الله. What does it mean؟ مع الله. Feeling the guardianship of Allah. Because you did صبر لله and you did صبر with Allah, then you reach this category which is your feeling. You know, the water is so cold, but I have no hot water. I'm going to make wudu with this water, right? You know, because now I feel the sweetness of Iman. I'm going to do and go through this patience because it's not comfortable, right? But I'm going to do it, you know, and I'm walking to the masjid and I'm driving early in the morning to come to the masjid. It's hard, but I'm doing it because you're feeling istishar. You're feeling the guardianship. You're feeling the companionship. You're feeling the support and the presence of Allah. This is what it means. As-sabr ma'a Allah. Allah will guard you. Allah will be your companion. Because you did sabr billah and sabr lillah. Oh, what a beautiful concept. لن تصبر حتى يكون صبرك له وصبرك به سبحانه وتعالى. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إن الله مع المتقين إن الله مع الصابرين. Allah is with الصابرين. Allah is with you. Allah is with me. Allah is with everyone. With what? With His knowledge, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows. But there is another type of ma'a. There's another type of ma'iyya. There's another type of guardianship or togetherness. Let's call it togetherness. Ma'a. With. There's another type here. Here, I'm going to explain it to you here, inshaAllah ta'ala. For instance, إن الله مع الصابرين. This معية, there are two types of معية. I'm going to call it عربية معية. مع. مع means with. معية. Let's call it معية. Or presence, or companionship, or guardianship. There are two types. There is one of العلم ومعية النصر والتأييد. معية العلم ومعية النصر والعلم. What does that mean? Let me explain it to you and you'll love it, inshaAllah ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ مُحْسِنُونَ. Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. This is the second type of ma'iyyah, which means the ma'iyyah of companionship, of victory, of support. He will give you the support. He will guard you. He will support you. He will protect you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the other one, the ma'iyyah of al-ilm. What is ma'iyyah of ilm? Knowledge. Allah subhanahu says, مَا يَكُونُ مِن نَجْوَى إِلَّا هُوَ ثَالِثُهُمْ مَا يَكُونُ مِن نَجْوَى If there's a third, he will be the fourth. If there is four, he will be the fifth. يعني, this is the ma'iyyah of amma. This is a generic type of ma'iyyah. Allah is with all, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the other type of ma'iyyah, when Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَى Allah is with the sabirin. What kind of ma'iyyah here? The ma'iyyah of support. He will support you. He will guard you. He will protect you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will give you victory, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now we can say that these two types of ma'iyyah, generic and amma, and khassa, specific and generic. Ma'iyyah mutlaqa. Mutlaqa means generic. Allah is with all, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows. He knows you, he knows the believer, he knows the non-believer, he knows the kafir. He's with all with his knowledge. He knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there is also a very specific ma'iyyah. Al-ma'iyyah li-awliya'ih. Al-ma'iyyah li-rasulih wa li-ibadihi s-salihin. What does that mean? Al-ma'iyyah, very specific to particular people, particular person. I'm going to try to make it, because this is very important, that's why I don't want to pause here. I want to finish this segment, and inshallah ta'ala, so we can move on to something else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالَ إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى Allah Azza wa Jalla told Musa and Harun, إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَى I am with you, I hear, and I see, I hear, and I see, مَعَكُمَا This is to particular people. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, كَلَّا إِنَّ مَعِي رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ مَنْ قَالَ هَذَا؟ إِبْرَاهِيمُ إِنَّ مَعِي رَبِّي Allah is with me, سَيَهْدِينَ He will guide me. A particular person, إِنَّ مَعِي مَعِي Allah is with me. No, this is to a particular person. A person. With Muhammad and Abu Bakr. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say when they were in the cave? ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إذ قال إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا Don't be sad. When Prophet Muhammad was there, then Abu Bakr was really worried. So Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed, you know, when he told his friend, when Prophet Muhammad told his friend, لا تحزن, don't be sad. Allah is with us. Very specific people. إذ يوحي ربك to the angels إذ يوحي ربك إلى الملائكة أني معكم فثبتوا الذين آمنوا even to the angels when they came to Surah into Badr you know إذ يوحي ربك إلى الملائكة Allah revealed to the angels I am with you very specific type of ma'iyyah I am with you but there is a very this is generic but there is also another type of togetherness, which is more beloved, which is very interesting, which is very, very beautiful. This applies to specific qualities and attributes. If you have this quality, Allah will be with you. Brother, if Allah is with you, who can defeat you? If Allah is with you, can anybody harm you? So if you have this quality, Allah will be with you. What is this quality? إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ Allah is with the sabirin. If you are patient, Allah will be with you. Inna Allah ma'al muttaqin. Allah is with al-muttaqin, righteous. If you're righteous, Allah will be with you. The other one is only specific, at a specific time. When they were in the cave, I'm with you. When you go into me, I am with you. But here, he will be with you constantly, if you are patient. If you're righteous, he will be with you constantly, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if he's with you, He will be your companionship and your guardian, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah ma'al ladina attaqaw. Ala inna awliya Allah la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun. La awliya. Who's the awliya? The wali. The wali is the one who's guardian, like the saint. But who are the saint? Alladina la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who have nothing to fear and nothing to be said about, Allah will be with them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah moves, and I would stop here inshallah, or pause right here after this particular ayah. Allah moves to people who will show the greatest amount of sabr. Who are these people? Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ بَلْ أَحْيَاءُ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. Right after sabr, Allah talks about a huge, very, 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 you know, great ayah. In terms of its magnitude, we're talking about sabr, sabr, and then Allah talks about those who show the greatest amount of sabr. Who are they? Allah says, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٍ. And do not, Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not and never say that those who got martyred in the cause of Allah, dead. وَلَكِن, they are, in fact, they are alive. They are alive. وَلَكِن, بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ, that you do not perceive it. That أحياء, like the Prophet Muhammad says when he talks about the martyr, he says his soul is in the belly of this green bird and they are flying all over Jannah. يَتَنَحَّمُونَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Shuhada and shaheed before you go. الشهيد. الشهيد shows lots of patience before being shaheed. For him to earn this title, shaheed, he must have manifested lots of endurance and patience. لا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله. Don't say to those who get killed في سبيل الله as they are dead. No, they are not dead. They are shaheed. They are alive as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here, the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, when he talks about, again, the shaheed, you know, when he talks about the different categories of shuhada, I will give you something before you go home. Al-shaheed or al-shahada, shahada comes from shaheed, is of categories. There are many categories. Al-shahada, aqsam, or darajat. Afdalu al-shuhada, shaheedul kalima. Kama qala alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, afdalul jihad. ما هو أنا اللي قلت أفضل الجهاد كلمة حق أمام سلطان جائر. The greatest, there's many categories of shaheed on shuhada. The Prophet mentions here that the greatest or the highest category of martyrdom is a truth to be said to a tyrant. If the tyrant was to kill that person, he's shaheed, and that is the greatest jihad. A tyrant king, a tyrant person, and then you're going to tell him you are wrong, and you try to tell him that why he's wrong, and then he kills that person is considered to be the greatest shaheed. There are two types, shaheedul kalima wa shaheedul ma'raka. Shaheedul kalima, I'm going to give you who is the shaheedul kalima. Shaheedul kalima means the word. Shaheedul kalima is shaheed Yasin. Who's Yasin? And shaheed al-ma'raka is who? The greatest shaheed of the kalima is shaheed Yasin. And the greatest shaheed of al-ma'raka, of the battle, is who? Hamza. Hamza sayyid al-shuhada. Wa the greatest shaheed al-kalima, shaheed Yasin, man huwa? Next week. Next week. But I'll tell you something else. وهناك ملحقون بالشهداء. Please take this. If you did not learn nothing today, just learn this. بس هذه ها. إذا ما استفدت ولا شيء اليوم, بس خذ هذه من عندي وخلاص وطلع. الملحقون بالشهداء. Another category of شهداء. And I will explain more next week, inshallah تعالى. There's something called الملحقون بالشهداء. من هم الملحقون بالشهداء؟ الذين قتلوا أو قتلهم الجن مثلاً. الذين قتلوا بأمراض زي مرض الطاعون والذين ماتوا بالسرطان فهم شهداء. الدهم والردم, الهدم والردم والغريق والحريق, كلهم شهداء. It's been said that maybe the majority, once we finish this you will understand, the majority of this ummah will die shaheed. Not necessarily in the battlefield. No. Not necessarily. يعني when I explain to you the categories of shahada or martyrdom, who's not going to die as shaheed? Who? To do all this? Maybe everybody. Why? Whom? I will explain better. But I had to say this, that even those who die off of cancer or anything that dies off of belly or whatever, ta'un or plague or whatnot, and today ta'un, the plague is maybe a form of cancer. Those who died through, because the jinn from sihr, it could be, you know, this disease that this person has gotten from jinn, because this, yeah, a lot of people, they related this cancer to ayn, to sihr, to mas, they are shaheed.
Sheikh, I have a question.
How? Lisa wasil anta, lisa jahil. Just kidding. How? Insha'Allah ta'ala, next week I will prolong on this particular topic just to explain this concept, insha'Allah ta'ala. Tafadhal Habibna, we have 10 minutes.
My wife uncle was walking in the street and a bullet hit him.
هذا نعم طيب يعني هذا الله أكبر نحسبه شيء. You see, you and I, number one, somebody came and then, you know, he was walking and he got hit by a bullet. You know, get bullet by bullet. You know, just like the Sahabiya who came to Rasulullah when her son was dying, you know, or got killed قبل معركة, before the معركة, Sahm came from nowhere.
I don't know the story.
Oh man, the Sahm came from nowhere before the معركة, Badr. Ya Rasulullah, my son got killed, tell me where he is. Wallahi, if he's not in Jannah, I will show you what I will do. Why? Because the معركة didn't start yet. The معركة didn't start, the battle didn't start. So she, then the Prophet said, Taqillah, your son is not just shaheed, he has reached al-Firdaus al-A'la. So you're saying about he was walking and then some bullet came from nowhere. He was not holding a gun, but the bullet came from nowhere. نحسبه شهيد. You and I, we cannot say that, and it's only for the Prophet to say, because you and I don't know the unseen, but anybody who dies, like al-Asa, Asa al-Akhuna Habib, Hada, huh? No need to mention the name, huh? Al-Sirwan, ughiru, huh? نحسبهم شهداء. We deem that they are shaheed. You and I, we cannot say for sure that they are. ولكن نحسبهم, but you know, because Allah says ونصطفي الشهداء. Because Allah says, and we select those whom will be shuhada. But inshallah ta'ala, after I explain this portion to you, inshallah, probably all of us will die shaheed بإذن الله.
But then الشهيد يأتي بالشفاعة.
نعم, of course, the shaheed, one of the merits of the shaheed, he will be able to intercede for his, you know, for his people. And also we're talking about the shaheed of al-kalima. You know, again, the shaheed is not the shaheed of the martyr of the in the battlefield, but the shaheed, because the Prophet saw this man and the Sahaba, they saw this man fighting. The Prophet says he's from hellfire. How can he be from the hellfire? You know, Ya Rasulullah, he's fighting bravely. Allah, he's from the people of hellfire. And then at the end, what happened? He was injured, he had wounded, and he could not be, and then he stabbed himself and he killed himself. Then the Prophet said, you know, give the cloud dying to the one who kills himself with the, you know, with Jahannam. So this is why you and I, we cannot say, but inshallah we say, inshallah shaheed fi sabilillah. Please help yourself with ashay before the adhan. We have 10 minutes.